in from the regions to gather at the People's House. Facing a season some are branding the Summer of Discontent amid a texting leak involving the party's leader.
That comment was made, which was supposed to remain private, which was never supposed to be forwarded on, but that happened and that was my fault.
Revelations the Deputy Prime Minister called Scott Morrison a hypocrite and a liar last year, met with forgiveness by the PM and dismay from some Nationals.
Damaging, unfortunate, and not focused on what we ought to be focused on, and that is indeed the people of Australia.
The junior coalition party room meeting in private this afternoon, where they were expected to vent their frustrations, as Mr. Joyce's predecessor used a national television appearance to offer his services again.
If enough members of the party came to me and said they want me to lead the party again, well, I would certainly seriously consider that. I've taken them to an election.
Other MPs downplaying that prospect.
I'm not going to comment on what my other colleagues are aspiring to. I think there's 21 in that party room that want to be leader.
I'm sure there's any number of people who are interested. The reality is very straightforward. Barnaby has the support of the room. There is no vacancy.
It's not just this leak that continues to distract, but another exchange reportedly between former New South Wales Premier Gladys Berejiklian and a senior Liberal cabinet minister. The level of tension inside the government showing when a former Labor politician suggested the anonymous minister was Peter Dutton. The defence minister took to social media to say the allegation was baseless and untrue. With Parliament resuming tomorrow, the government has its last chance to legislate before the budget in March and likely an election in May. Time is running out and it appears key promises from 2019 are unlikely to be fulfilled.
The term is not completed yet.
Establishing a National Anti-Corruption Commission and an Indigenous voice to Parliament both likely off the agenda until after the election. The priority now, legislating a religious discrimination bill while amending the Sex Discrimination Act to protect gay students. And today, a decision made in 2018 reversed. The federal government will end an indexation freeze of the ABC. Over the next 3 years, the ABC will receive $3.3 billion. SBS more than $950 million.
We're committing to ABC and SBS funding for the coming 3 year period, around $4.2 billion across both of our national broadcasters.
Pablo Viñales, SBS World News.